12th, welcome to you all to the Paramita TED Talk. Let us start our session by considering the present situation of our society. In this physical growing world, at least 2 out of 3 people will say that they have many problems in their life. Problem is one which is answerable, which have a solution. But people just say, I have many problems in my life, please don't disturb. I think I have experienced such situations. You might have not only listened, but I also uttered the same. Okay. Now let us take a situation. Just imagine you met a new friend or a new colleague. What do you do first? You generally show yourself, right? Like you introduce yourself. You'll start with your name and native place. Yes? Okay. Now let us take another situation. Just imagine that you confronted with a new problem. Instead of a human being, now there is a problem. Look, when you meet a new friend, you'll just introduce yourself. But when a new problem arises, why don't you show yourself? By the end of my talk, you'll understand how to show yourself to your problems. To show yourself to your problems, firstly, you need to believe in yourself. To start believing in yourself, it will take some time. Belief is something which can change your fate. There is a famous quote said by Mariella Ritten, 1984 Olympic gymnastic winner, that is, believe the unbelievable. I repeat it again, believe the unbelievable. Take some time and understand it clearly when you are free. I'll say that problems and setbacks are inevitable in life. We cannot stop the rising problem, but we can solve the problem. I'll tell you how strong the belief is by narrating a story. Once there lived 2 boys named Jack and John who lived in a village near Olenburg. Jack was 6 years old and whereas John was 10. So they were very close friends and spent most of the time together. So one day as part of an adventure, they went a little too far from their village. While they were running and exploring, John fell into the well. He started screaming because he didn't know how to swim and thought he would drown and die. Jack panicked and looked around for help, but he saw a bucket tied to a rope lying nearby. By without wasting any time, he threw the bucket into the well and asked John to hold the bucket. The moment John held the bucket, he started pulling it. He pulled and pulled and pulled till John was out of the well. They both were happy and cheering and ran quickly towards their home. They told the families and their villagers about this event. Nobody believed them because Uncle Peter only believed them because Jack was too weak to lift a bucket full of water and thought how could he lift John out of the well. Only Uncle Peter believed and villagers came to Uncle Peter and asked how could this be possible. Then Uncle Peter laughed and said, what is there to explain? The boy is already telling you how he did it. He threw the bucket into the well and pulled the rope to save his friend. What's strange here is that how could he gather all the strength? That is, at that time, there was nobody around him to tell him that he could not do it. And he himself was not in a position to think so. He added, the only one who can empower you is yourself. The best version of life is the only you, and that's the power of you. Then villagers realize how important to believe in yourself. To start believing in yourself, you need to trust your heart, which actually shows your inner strength, due to which you can recreate a new life within your life. You know, this belief and trust will give energy to your brain, and due to which you can train your mind. I think a question raised in a few minds that can mind get trained? Here the answer goes, you have to train your mind like you train your body. Look, we eat food to get work done physically. In the same way, there should be some food even to your brain so that it will gain energy. And that food will not be sold in the market like vegetables. That food will be prepared within you. Only if you increase your belief and trust coherently, then it will give energy to your brain, then you will have solution for every problem. And that strength will give you confidence. And that confidence makes you to get solution. I have created a formula. To create this formula, a mathematician is not required. Belief in the presence of trust on your heart gives rise to strength, which employs confidence. Remember it. Belief in the presence of trust on your heart gives rise to strength, which employs confidence. If trust on your heart is there within you, then the belief that takes birth in you will give strength, due to which you will get confidence and you will solve the problems very easily. In future, if you face any problems, just introduce to your problems that you have more strength and confidence in you. Then problems will understand that you are born to crush the problems. And they'll think that you are tough nut to crack. And they will run away from you. Surely, they will run far away from you. Dear friends, I do the same. I hope you all will do the same in future. So finally, I say that what you believe, you receive. Believe that you are born to achieve. Believe in yourself, you will be unstoppable. So, be strong and confident and make yourself problem resistant and show yourself to your obstacles that you are tough nut to crack. Thank you, thank you, thank you.